Oh, no. Now we've got Starnan claiming that the iridescent hoard here is a hugbox.
All I'm seeing is someone actually defending
the Great Tragula there.
Great Tragula, I want to rise again, and the
Great Tragula is now building up some player allies.
Yeah, we can see something mounting here. It might take a bit of sweet talking to get some others on board. I think Rurik is out of the question here, but if they could maybe, just maybe, get Palambang on their side.
Yeah, they're an AI, so they're going to have to do a bit of kind of fancy footwork there.
Oh, they rivaled them. That might have been a big mistake for the greatest Tragula.
Can you get then... How about Gneevnob? Can he get him on board?
Well, they allied with the Oda. Gneevnob, well. There's a lot. Oh man, Sheridan just fell into Regency when we were looking at it there. But I think it would be clever for the Menith to notice this wall of death that's approaching.
Yes, it might be time to find some allies there, or some canopy allies. Mm-hmm.
Wow, I didn't expect this kind of inoptimal play from the Starman, but he hasn't placed his merchants at all. He's actually hemorrhaging money in his own way.
Yes.
Not that we will show favoritism by pointing this out to players. And
no, but I'm assuming
we're not here. We're not here to play for them. Was that a 14-year regency? No, not quite 14 years.
But it's getting there. It's not the shortest regency.
Good thing he already started a war before he fell into that, but he's going to regret not having got himself a...
new consort. Alright, there's Bratton.
Oh, Bratton's taken over. He saw where the institutions are spreading and he's going to have it.
Oh, where's these armies are heading south?
What's he up to there?
Can't go
okay. Oh. Matahan, we're hiding down in the Swede. Swedes are always just hiding these enemies.
Yes.
Come on, show us what you're made of on the battlefield.
Oh, they were. Victory.
A slaughter.
One hell of a beating.
He doesn't know where he's going.
Variety. You know, that's the thing about choices.
Okay, gotta hand it to Krakow. They're looking pretty mighty just sitting there chilling, allied with Sweden.
Meanwhile, yes, Katsinia showing cats how it's done.
Mm-hmm. Okay, they're taking over the Abenaki. Is this going to be a one shot? It could well be.
Will he get a coalition, though? Can he outdo Johan here on coalitions?
Yeah, that's worth remembering. He is North, this land is Catholic. That's going to be extra aggressive expansion. But it's not that there are a huge number of Catholics up here. I mean, this is far away from... It's not like conquering a Germanic nation where all the other Germans are going to throw a hissy fit. These are Swedes.
Yes, you know? And who cares about them?
Yeah, really. I wonder if Sweden down here actually maintains Swedish culture. No, they are Sicilian through and through, but they still have their Swedish traditions.
Well, that's fair enough.
Took it with them.
I'm a traditionalist myself. I like people who respect tradition.
Somebody's asking if there's any Prussian culture left. Riga's still holding... Well, what was once Riga, still holding it. Palembang holding on to the only Prussian culture around. So plenty of wars we've seen. So far we have seen two nations get very nearly destroyed. I think if Great Tragula was reduced any more, I'd say he's out of this.
It's going to take some fancy footwork.
But you know, he's got two allies. But it's the Iridescent Horde that have built up a fair amount. So seems that he's got something worked out with the Grugmeister, which seems to be Grug, he can't have this.
Otherwise,
they must be working something out with the Fido here.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Fido.
But here's the thing: the Iridescent Horde are going to find themselves a bit locked in if the Kuba Lubens
keep on going.
Mm-hmm. They're going to have to work something out there.
Oh, have we looked at the ideas of the Iridescent Horde?
We have, probably not. Let's go check them out. So we already saw that they are the Ottoman government type, so they get to enjoy some pretty sweet rulers.
Yeah, and however, it does mean the end of their Glitterhoof dynasty.
Yeah, what a shame there. Iridescent Horde ideas. They start off with cavalry combat ability and cavalry ratio.
Oh, that's a lot of cavalry
Wow. Now, if they can afford it, they could just... Look at that. Look at that cavalry stack. That would destroy most things they touch. Mm-hmm. And straight away, they're going for morale of their armies.
Yeah, EK just announces that the Great Horde has left the building.
They'll be back.
They'll be back and in greater numbers.
Yes. You strike them down, they'll come back stronger. The great horde. And greater than ever before.
The great horde startles easily.
So the heroes of horse kind, it's well known to, I think a lot of these are going to fall flat without the Glitter Hoof dynasty.
Yes, I know. I think
charge.
It made far more with the
Terror of the Wild Plains, to name a few. This greatly increases the morale of our steeds, rather. No one national flag. No, I think we have one right there.
I think there is one national flag there, but mm-hmm. Yes.
Multicolored cavalry uniforms giving flanking extra flanking ability for the cavalry.
I'm not sure how those two, but apparently it's true.
No. There's nothing as awe-inspiring or confusing as a mass of horsemen in multicolored garb. It's like the Mongol version of Joseph in the Technicolor Dreamcoat right here.
No horsing around.
No, please. When it comes to taxing the peasants, there can be no compromise. Yeah, fair enough. Right. First drafted by the magnificent advisor to the Roman Emperor.
Caligula, ooh.
Oh, well, did he come from here? Because I
don't know.
It's like a reverse row. This is the Western Roman Emperor. They used to have all this, you see, and now it just split and broke down. Like rider, like steed, to give extra shock damage. Merciless in melee. Plenty of horsepower.
Oh.
I think we heard that one before. Oh. The economy is built on the backs of horses. And then prismatic
parades. Oh dear, mm-hmm. With extra prestige.
Onlookers permanently blinded each time. With state maintenance reduction as well. Oh my, Grugi's maybe going to need to hire out some horses to deal with this.
Yeah, he's got some lolhard heretics there.
Yeah, he actually just fed a general trait to the heretics here.
Dear.
So born, not looking good for
born to the saddle.
Only one person could possibly take those down. So those truce timers ticking away for the poor Tragula. Can he
assemble a good enough alliance in time? Time will tell.
I gotta be honest, I don't think so.
Dear.
Rurik would have to... You know, I'd strike a deal and say, Rurik, look, you chose poorly. You can survive if you switch sides now, otherwise you die. Because your friends are not your friends. And you don't have any friends.
Yes, apart from that.
Apart from that trifling detail. You know, it's not like they're all that bad. I mean, they start with good morale and discipline. You're going to need that against the Prus.
Okay, shall we check out our...
Somebody's asking if Byzantium exists. Well, that doesn't tell us everything. Because we can't see the whole world. We'll explore just a little bit more. Because I'm curious myself. Nope.
No Byzantium.
As far as we know, they might, just might be hanging around over here or over there, but...
They're definitely well hidden.
Actually, since there's no big player wars going on at the moment, there's no shortage of wars since Vandalia is actually hoovering up. Why don't we take a look at Asia? Because we haven't given them a good time of day.
No.
Starting with India here, we've got mighty Berar to the north. Riga looking super strong.
And Rwanda as well. Yeah. No, they're more than just a hotel.
Aye. But Yi is the one really taking over here. Yeah. They just need to slash down on the last of Jampur, who are feeling probably horribly emasculated down here.
Yes, Jampur, just really not a lucky country.
They chose Jampurly.
Yes.
It's worth getting a good idea of the development we have here as well. So, okay, real strength lies in Riga. As always, the Uzbek, not to be sniffed at either. But the real place to be is over in Panipat,
I think. And who owns that?
Yeah, that belongs to the...
Whatever.
Yeah, these guys. Them. Wow, kind of missed that purple, but they're hanging around with
Chilling, their national
ideas.
Doing their thing.
Madurai feeling a bit displaced, as are Kandar and Ceylon. Yeah, good going, Ceylon. Tio, mighty Tio.
And look at the size of Augsburg there.
There we go. Free city no more. They're still free.
Yeah, but they're free. They've let go. They have transcended out from their city status. I just hope they're Buddhist, because that would really complete it.
The Ashikaga Oligarchic Republic are down here. There we go.
Yes.
Theravada Buddhist.
That's...
Naj have settled down right here. We've got Mam Huang, Nassau, Mixtec, not Mexico, that's what I thought they might have been. And what's the Aachen?
Yes, where else?
Spicy Aachen.
Yes.
Not bad. Cochin looking mighty in pink there. Chickshaw taking over southern China. Tila, we've got Ravensburg. They're going to be the real heir to the Emperor of China. Emperor Ravensburg?
Yes.
Emperor Mughal.
As it should be.
Yeah. And that means they took it away because somebody else was the emperor before, weren't they?
I think so.
I'm pretty sure.
Check out that Albania there.
Who was the previous emperor then?
Lebanon.
Kixi Shia. Oh yeah, Lebanon. Do you see a Lebanon? I don't see a Lebanon. Oh, there we go.
What's left of Lebanon.
Yeah, the great emperor. What, he had a lot. From,
yes, Lebanon, no more.
Yeah. Got the Funj, the Ashanti, the Jimas. Jimas hiding over there. Just want to have a quick check to make sure there's no huge wars going on. Got to keep on top of that. The Karaman. But do we have anything over in the Siberian? Yeah, well, Shandy, East Siberia. What are they like?
Look at Ferrara there. Check out that Ferrara.
Not bad. They got the gold.
Yes.
And then Japan's a right mess. Who do we have here? I've got Dongola, who's the daimyo here. But who do we have?
Normandy there.
Right.
Everyone's favourite daimyo.
Who's our shogun?
Arabia.
Arabia
is the shogun.
My greatest ally when I played MP, Arabia. They're taking over. It's okay. Interesting times over in Asia for sure.
Look at that Congo there, sitting.
The Irish have been misplaced here.
Yes.
Where you say, oh, Congo. Ooh.
That's awesome.
Feeling a bit lost.
That's an awesome Congo.
Now, what I want to know.
But look, Oriat is almost in the right place.
Wow! I think that's an Oirat province.
My goodness me.
It had to happen to somebody.
What is wrong with this stream? No. We will see about trying to correct that.
Yeah. Also, Delhi very close to being where they should be. Oh, didn't see the Mongols there.
Yes.
What I'm curious is if there are any gold provinces that have obscene production value. So if we check for the gold and just try to see. Okay, so we got six load of gold down in Chicxulub, because these provinces are going to be highly in demand. If any of our players make their way there. Now, Golconda is the best gold mine in the world normally. It's actually... All right, so here we go. Mawar.
Eight production. That's quite a bit of gold there.
Incredible. Yeah. Just two over there. And there's also... seven. Seven for Gnevum here.
Yeah, I think he might have done a little cheeky upgrade there.
Possibly.
Yeah, now Millhaven's also...
Oh, it's been improved 10 times. Six over there for Tyrol, so that's good news for Menneth there. And then two more to check out, just one there and one there. Now, unfortunately, apparently I hear Chris Jacobson is dead.
What?
Replaced with this poser.
Call that a monarch.
Yeah, I'm disappointed.
Well, I think that's his starting one, isn't it?
Oh, it is.
It's his heir there, Ambrose. 5-1-3, that's poor.
Obsessive perfection. When have we ever let perfection get in the way of a good job?
It's sad. Oh. I think I'll just... You got a black armband handy?
Tragic times. Okay, so there's war going on right now. Starnan is taking on the Rurik. Oh, there's no loyalty. No loyalty whatsoever here.
And Rurik is on his own.
Yeah, but this is dangerous because that's yet more land for the Starnan to eat up and nobody really opposing that.
Will we see?
This is where the real politics should jump in and everybody should ally Rurik against this monstrosity.
Yes, I mean, you can't let Starnan get momentum here.
Yeah, but the Iridescent Horde seem to be busy with their own things going on. Same with Nevaluki. Even Sheridan, who's probably
still
itching
Regency,
for a fight.
So he's going to need to join in someone else's ball.
Nobody helping out the poor Arlaser over in Rurik.
Don't worry, our laser. We'll get you a stiff drink afterwards here.
Did we ever check out the Rurik ideas? Yeah, he had the morale there, but he's got...
And discipline there.
Force limit, I don't think he's going to be seeing any of that. That's a decent admin efficiency early, though. Great feasts! The children of our advisors should follow in their parents' footsteps, ensuring that we all never lack advisors of any sort. So, Surt's Fury, Return of the Nornir.
I like Return of the Mac.
The Varangian Pragmatism. Efficient Conquest, Serf Militia. It's all amounting to nought as he gets
He just got stuck by there, rather sadly. Meanwhile, Johan is taking on Switzerland here. because you know
someone's got to take care of those imposters.
Yes, well, I mean, with in a you know, with your enemy, you know where you stand. You can't trust these neutrals.
Aye, Swiss have got to go.
And should we remind people that if they haven't bought a ticket for PDXCon, they should.
Now, if you're here because you just love seeing so much of these live streams,
if you like full Scottish streams,
then don't worry, because Chris and I will be there to put the con in PDXCon.
Yes.
We managed to we very slyly managed to secure our own little
We've got our own slot there. Yeah. We have the Jake and Chris EU4 live stream.
Not streamed.
It's a live stream that is live, but not streamed.
Yeah.
It's just so amazing.
Yeah. So I think tickets are still
if you still
available.
Have a chance to get a ticket.
Yeah.
And you enjoy the stream. And even if you don't enjoy the stream, just buy a ticket. You know.
Go there, so at least you can be there going boo.
Yes, if you you know, we try not to throw too much rotten fruit. That's all I want to say.
Throw some fresh fruit. Come on. At least then we can produce. Oh my! Oh my!
Oh dear.
Poor Rorik is
not
feeling so great here, but I think what's happening here is Millhaven wants to feed there we go. Feeding everything they can to the Prus so they can afford bigger army to use all those massive bonuses.
Are we a pair of con men? I prefer creative. Yes, Darnan is a bit of a submissive here.
Yeah. Oh, throw some pineapples. That might hurt a bit.
Well, it's definitely something different.
So, but I just don't get it. Nobody is stepping up to oppose the Prus, and he's got all this.
Are they waiting for a nerf, do you think?
We just have to wait 10 more minutes. We can get that nerf in for,
next week, sir.
Because when you look at it, that is...
Is that 20% there? I can see a nerf bat being unleashed on that one.
Oh, it's going to be my call to make.
But yes.
I'm not so sure about the percentage. I think that if you reach a certain size, then it shouldn't.
If you get too much.
Like, if you're over 200 or.
Say 186 developments. For example.
That's where it goes. There is a level at which the March modifiers stop affecting you.
Yes.
Because normally you get the other stuff, which is. I don't know. Does anybody have a vassal that we can look at?
Cause there's one.
That's a march there. I need somebody who just plain has a vassal. There we go. So these guys right here, the Vandalias, they've got their Salish people here. And if they were to make them a march, see all these nice bonuses. Manpower, recovery speed, force limit, maintenance, defense. Pretty beautiful.
Yes, it's pure poetry there.
Aye. I think once a certain point is reached, then those need to call canny and get rid of that.
Mm-hmm.
But... the thing is, after each session, people always retire to their respective drinking halls and discuss the day's events.
Yes.
So suspect.
I think we will get our laser stiff drink.
He's gonna need it.
Because you're also gonna see the thing about our laser is he brought the fight. Just people brought more fight than he did.
Well, you got to remember one of.
He's also being attacked again.
By the AI. You've got to give it to them. You know, feeding Palembang is the only way they can put up a decent fight against the Prus.
Yes.
You've got to do it for the greater good, our laser.
Yes. All right, request to see Alexandria. Well, okay. We still can.
Okay, here we go. They also wanted to see Africa. So whilst you're drinking in the imagery there, Alexandrian ideas. Actually, what are they boasting here? They're first in Ikta. With, I've seen better.
Bishop.
In Besler as well. So they are a monastic order.
Yes, they are a Coptic.
Metropolis in Metropolis. So what are they enjoying? They're getting tech cost and idea cost, or admin tech cost.
This is obviously playing the long game here.
Definitely.
He's hoping that people will leave
army tradition from battles from enlisted observers.
100%.
Fortification standards for fort defense. War exhaustion reduction, some fort maintenance. Core creation cost reduction. Attrition, years of separatism. So nothing military there. No morale, no discipline, no shock damage. I wonder what he's going for. Is he trying to be an economical backbone or something? Well, he is Coptic at least.
Someone's attacking poor Magni.
Oh no. Oh, who would have thought the free conquest of Wien?
Oh no. Poor Mehmeth there. it's...
Menneth had his quote being, if at first you don't succeed, maybe someone will take pity on you.
Well, apparently, he's obviously been too successful.
Aye. I'm going to go and flick that TV on again. It seems to have given up the ghost for
us. I will hold the fort.
You cover for me.
Yes, no one will notice you're gone. I will just hold on there. Yes, poor Menneth here. It's all going a bit peak-tong here. I mean, if we look here, his canopy's not ideal. But as we can see, not much land occupied yet.
We need less of this energy-saving nonsense and more of this TV working. There we go.
There we go, excellent there, less energy. Yes, let's see, what is this war about?
It was the conquest of Vienna, was it or not?
Conquest of Vienna. Yes, I don't speak foreign.
I mean, you remove the Ottomans from the game and just something else big and green takes its place.
Yes.
So, I gotta say, I don't think he's gonna fare too well here. He had no allies. Why did he have no allies? You don't just sit there and expect them to roll in. So he has no manpower as well. He exhausted himself fighting north, but he just could not play the diplomatic game here.
And there's quite a lot here, but this is a hug box to match...
Yeah, well, you know, maybe they're trying to get together here and saying, if we don't eat and kind of link together here,
then
this is going to be an issue.
Yes, I can
but
see that.
But notice that Millhaven is struggling to get allies here. Yes. I don't think anybody really wants to help them grow much more here. But these guys, they seem to be going, right, if we don't shape up, we're shipping out.
Yes, it's a... Oh, all right, Mammoth is just clarifying here that... He basically lost all his men fighting them.
Well, no, he, look, this is an army.
Yes, he's
They're even brandishing the Paradox logo.
Yes, he's gone for the Paradox logo here.
Probably thinking that might offer him some protection. It's like, surely nobody would attack it. Nope. Down it goes.
Yes. That's obviously...
Well, maybe he'll throw a Hail Mary here. He seems to be recruiting all he can.
He's building up something. He's gonna...
Oh, he's loaning hard.
Yes.
He's going in.
Stand back, chaps. Oh.
So he...
He's gotta win
he
this.
He does have morale on his side. Oh, wow, he's doing not too shabby here. If he can just wipe them out.
Oh, no.
They got the reinforcements. No, line is breaking.
No, and there comes the next set of reinforcements here. It was a bold move there.
He tried.
He just tried.
Not hard enough.
But yes, God loves a trier.
Mm. If God had loved him, they wouldn't have sent Marco.
Yes, that's true. Well, Marco maybe is the scourge of God.
Yeah.
Now, St. Johann is back rolling again. Has he got...
What is this? The Gutnish tried to take over the Shan, and Britannia was having none of that.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, the
so
Holy Order...
Has he got another coalition going?
Holy Order of Not Johann. He's treading a much finer line this time.
Yes, how about cats? Has he got any hint of coalition goodness?
No, it was all localised up here.
Yes.
And I don't think the Abenaki's remnants are going to be doing much about it. But there's the thing. Fido is not an aggressive player. I reckon a lot of other players would have instantly leapt to eat this up and keep cats pinned in. But
well, also, we don't know about the diplomacy. I've tried to stay out of it because really... I find it formed part of the meta game where people would hint about alliances that weren't happening and all these kind of things. Now, wait a minute, has Trintragula? Oh, yeah, we should probably just.
Yeah. we got a little independent observer saying that perhaps we should check out the Menneth ideas.
Yes.
Before.
All right, so.
So, what's he boasting right now? He's a theocracy, as we saw before. Decent. No, I'm looking at the wrong guys again. How do I manage this?
He's an emirate there.
Of course, he was the Ottoman government, and he's got production quotas, veteran sergeants.
Mm-hmm.
Sergeants are the true leaders of the army. The officers are just there to prevent warfare becoming a more squabble between peasants. Military police, yeah, quite right. Efficient tax administration, established national army for land force limit, ruthless administration, and service guarantee system. But I see the problem here. He didn't write any of these.
No, I know.
I know because I wrote some of these.
I also wrote some of them as well.
Oh, boy.
I'm pretty sure service guarantees citizenship is one of mine, actually.
Like the Romans before us. Cannon fodder should prove easier and cheaper. It's got the Chris King flavour, doesn't it?
Yes. I mean,
Are these guys or are they not renewable resources though?
They're not renewable resources. Only Buddhists are not renewable resources.
We'll have to go and get some more.
Yes. Yes. Oh, sorry about that. Yes. Yeah. No. I also, other classics of mine include Equal Opportunity Butcher. Is also one of mine. That's in the military.
Yeah, I think it's under quantity.
The old
and the infirm. That's I don't think that was.
Maybe it's young conserve.
We should force people to volunteer. That sounds like one of yours, right?
Yeah, that's definitely one of mine.
We are an equal opportunity butcher. Yeah, the young conserve.
Most of these early ideas were written by me.
How old does a boy have to be before he is a man?
It's a good question.
Before he can die for his country. Okay, I just noticed a lot of fires lighting up for war here. Rurik is on his death row here.
Mm-hmm.
Defender against Great Tragulus. Tragulus.
So Trent Tragulus here, you've got to hand it to him, he's not going down without fight.
No, he is not.
It's like the famous headline, Dominatrix won't go down without fight.
No.
Yeah, so Rurik, it's all looking a bit grim for him.
No,
Arlazer, stiff drink, whiskey's on me, mate.
Yeah, I think. I'll just carry him into the watering hole.
Yes. You can take our laser to water, but can you make him drink?
Well, this can.
Yes. Okay. I think our question was, can we get him to stop drinking?
Yes. Can we get him home again?
Yes.
Oh. That's sad, though. But he brought it on himself. He backed the wrong horse.
Who then he backed Millhaven in Prussia, who turned out to be extremely xenophobic.
Rough times for the Ruriks there. People are asking to see if we haven't actually looked at our special QA's ideas.
We have two. We also haven't looked at Vandalia.
Vandalia
down there.
Yeah.
Vandams.
Yeah, the Vandams down there. Which movie are you going to reference for that one?
I don't know. There's so many high quality Van Damme movies. Cyborg with its dark dystopian future where all the women had these big 80s perms. It really was a terrible future.
So we've got I think that's the end.
Yes,
of
our laser has officially left
the building. Yes. Not rage quit, just plain quit. He no longer exists.
That's probably the biggest rage quit.
Okay, and wow, that's right at the 5 o'clock though. So before people come down, let's have a quick look at the, I hope this guy gets removed, because I don't even know how to say this. The nation of
fa.
Huge amounts of morale, shock damage received going way down, and legacy of King Midas. So
yes,
they are going for it.
Taxation there.
Yeah, we're getting that tax going. The Trojan War has taught them. They get extra infantry combat ability. Some productivity of King Gordius.
He's got a big knot going, I think.
Oh, aye. Dating back to the Gordian knot itself. The cult of Shebel, the Mountain Mother, giving more shock damage. So lots of people have gone fire, but these guys have gone shock, I see.
Fire!
We've got the doctrine of King Mygdon. Learned many important lessons when waging war against the Amazons.
Yes.
The spirit of subjugated people bring down the war exhaustion and collective administration.
We're
just talking about you.
Yes, famous. Your moments of fame here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just looking
through your ideas here.
Yeah. I really appreciate the way you fought Pegu, pieced out, and then let Grugi deal with all the aftermath.
Yeah, I mean, of course, why should I bother with the rest of them when I got the things I wanted from
you?
Yeah, everything you wanted.
That's the kind of thinking that put Millhaven and Prussen in front, so glad to see it's working for you as well.
Oh, yeah.
So can you tell us the inspiration behind your nation, though?
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of like a history geek, so I want to like have some form of historical basis for my nation. I just picked like Prig. I mean, it's perfect. It's in the area.
So what's your country name here? Because we can't pronounce it.
Yeah, I think it's called Prigia, but I'm not entirely sure, so don't quote me on it.
How's foreign policy for you? I mean, is there any animosity across the Strait of Marmara?
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of worried that he's going to go for me eventually, but we'll have to see.
He hasn't set your land as vital interest, you know? We know what he's going to say. He's like, I don't even want that.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I, I,
If he ends up at war with you, it's not a war he wanted.
Yes, right. No, peace is his profession.
Yeah, I mean, well, he's not called the player's slave for a reason, no?
Well, he'll come down and say it is for no reason.
Yes, he's deeply upset about the whole thing.
I'm
should we check? We actually got one last set of ideas to check, which is Vandalia.
Okay.
Jean-Claude Vandalia here. Carl Berg's ideas.
I wonder if he's going to come down, but oh well.
His
loss if he's not here. So we've got, starting off with the morale and shock damage. So
that's
again,
a pretty
for
solid one there.
Finishing with Army Tradition 2. We've got, what's it, the House Carl training, giving him infantry combat ability. So no egoism here.
Oh, right, yes, he's training Carl.
Valkyries. Giving that female again the mark of shame, bringing
it's mark of shame. Oh, come.
He is here. You can tell it's the inspiration behind your nation because you're I think the last one that we were looking at for ideas.
Yeah. So, it's the main inspiration is the Vandal country, the kingdom of the Vandals that existed there during, I think, year 400 to 600 something.
Are one people under Odin?
Yes. We're Vandals. We're aggressive conquerors, yeah.
But some people are good at writing shit.
Yeah.
I didn't bother.
Like me?
Yeah, we noticed that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was mostly because I kept, finding exploits and then outlawing them.
Yeah, I wonder who finds...
This has been warded.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Now we have to let it be.
Yes, well, you are the first coalition.
Now, you just have to cancel marches.
Why?
If you don't want the balance changes, we're doing
I rather want to balance changes.
No, I think it shouldn't apply above a certain development, and I think that's what the other bonuses already do.
A march bonus do not apply over 60 development, do they?
No.
Well, I don't need them.
Yeah.
No, I think it's the overlord bonus.
It's that send off. Well, we can have a look at that afterwards.
We'll discuss.
I mean, I should have a prize for being the sloppiest E4 player in a long time. It's like, I'm conquering. It's just free promises.
It's like Germanic culture.
Your fan base is turning against you here. How can you justify cooperative gameplay?
No, I wouldn't even call this cooperative. This is purely submissive.
Yes,
Delicious type.
You're
saying you're hogboxing. I have zero allies. How am I possible?
It's not the hogbox.
You are the bots.
Here comes the man you have to apologize for. He's like, 5 minutes after he has gotten we'll have a defensive pack.
What did you do?
I took a third low development province and all of Europe.
You're in two separate wars. We'll ally up, we'll take the rest of northern France, it'll be fine. And suddenly, bang, there's coalition fighting. Everything goes wrong.
I
had to press no when I saw that
one. I just assumed it's another war, I'll accept job done. But everybody attacked. Yeah. And then Iberia jumped
that
on
was,
me.
That was great, though. I really liked the comeback.
Well, you didn't know,
Iberia.
I had allies I hadn't already allied up with. I called on Dricus.
I saw him and I was like, wow, he's being sieged by everyone. I might not want to join this.
But it was three wars on this.
You got one hell of a payment out of this.
Oh, yes.
Look at that. 30, 44 development with an estuary and a trade center.
So Van
I'm not going to brag, but I earned that. I stack wiped him three times.
Yeah, I saw.
I saw. It wasn't battle. It was day one stack wipe.
Yes.
But he didn't take any military.
Yeah, Vassalia
went for provinces.
He went for quantity there. maybe he tried to make good ideas when he had the ugly ring nation, but when we slapped that one down.
Yeah.
But the problem was that he only started only doing diplomacy right before the game. Like 5 minutes before, he was like, hey, do you want to ally up? And I was like, sorry.
Oh, I haven't done anything.
I have allies.
It's like, well,
I talked a bit with your one. That's what it is.
Yeah. I talked with all my neighbors, except...
As you should.
I didn't... sorry, Magna, I didn't talk to you because...
I don't think anyone judging from this.
Everyone basically assumed he was going to die.
Poor guy. So no one attacked him or allied him.
He took some French provinces as well, so I'm going after
pretty unacceptable.
But Chris...
I mean, oh man, we have...
What?
We didn't read.
That's boring. We didn't have time to read through all of them, but we can.
But you know, post them up in the thread.
I like the Britannia. It's a nice color on the map.
Oh yeah,
it's a very soothing shade of in. Aqua there.
Trying to blend in with the sea. It's like
I don't exist.
I do like the idea of Gloucestershire being like the metropolis of the island.
Why are not the symbols on the flags?
On these ones.
Yeah.
That has never worked. I think.
Just like old man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, speaking of people that break alliances, there was a nation here. It had a good, strong alliance with the Millhaven Brood. Even helped you. I saw that war. Rurik died for you.
No.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
There is no nation on the map to recall of this. I think.
Well, I'm pretty sure there's still some cores.
What happened to the Great Tragulia?
So the thing was...
It's still there.
We're going to rename it Mediocre Tragulia.
So we made like a deal with Martin and Rika. Says like, yes, let's split up Lamander. And then he has like kill. Like they focused only on Rickard's armies because we couldn't get to him. And then straight after peace out, Jesper and his hogbox attacks Rickard.
Don't talk about hogboxes.
Hang on.
I have zero
afraid of hogboxes. What's this? After countless wars against hogbox, we are now more efficient at destroying them.
So you don't fear hogboxes. You don't fear that box.
You always fear the hogboxes. No, so like it was impossible for us to defend them because we had zero manpower, and then. Palembang, which is one of the largest nations in the world.
It wasn't impossible for the Italians to come over, or sorry, the Dutch Italians to come over and save Aquitaine. So.
Well, sure, if no one of them had any military ideas, I would have gone in. But now it was, I don't know, how many? Three? Okay. Two nations?
Yeah, you're 40 morale.
But everyone can breathe easy because... 40? Oh, well, no, regency has ended.
Yeah, finally.
Yeah, that one must have hurt. What? So, how many people had their amazing starting rulers that they made die instantly?
2 months it took.
I had mine die after, like, 1 month after I disinherited my 000 heir.
Yeah.
So I got a new dynasty now.
I also had time to disinherit, but that was hard.
2 months. 6 military, bold fighter, what else was he? He was, like, strict or something?
I even made him... I spent points on making him 9 years younger, like, before we started. Just because I didn't want him to die, and he has instantly died.
So. While my 000 became a 442 general and died...
We don't have any Buddhists here, but there is karma in Europe, that's right.
Yes. And how is Eastern... not Eastern, Middle East looking?
Well, if we see a bit more here.
Estereos is strong.
That's beautiful.
This is nice.
Or the Naha.
This is nicer, though. I like... So you've got Kuba Luba here. And then it's just like, okay. Hold on, this wasn't Langshang before.
No, it wasn't.
No,
this
was Shanda.
Shandi.
Ah, yes, Shanda was...
Yeah, Shandi's gone.
So they were killed by
all of this. Okay, well, good play on Shanda.
What's the great powers then, though?
Great powers, we're looking at Millhaven at number one.
Obviously Prussia, not a great power.
They're taking a Prussian dog out for a walk every now and then. Imperium, looking up at number two. Aquitaine at three. So two and three are in cahoots here. Only four for Marco, but I put that down to the Regency. Mm-hmm. Hail Britannia at five.
Never lucky.
Sorry, I was getting that.
Calm down.
Never looking good. Palembang still holding on, and they were part of the slaughtering our laser page.
He was expanding quick.
And then, good job, Emil. Gordian Knot will rise to power.
Yeah, whatever it is.
Nothing for Zakania, though.
I was a great power for two or three years, until, as long as the coalition were lost.
Now, Mehmet says, check out his losses.
I mean, he's... lost a fair bit already.
Talking about military losses.
Oh, right.
His army losses.
Okay, so if we check...
Who's the biggest loser here?
Not me this time.
They are the biggest loser on the map. But, the Dutch Talians...
Where am I?
Empire.
I'm pretty
Don't tell me I'm going to have to scroll to find the Prussians.
Okay, check out. Filter for players.
Peaceful this time.
Wow.
Losses.
You let everyone else fight your wars.
You let our laser bleed for you.
But then erased all evidence.
Oh, yeah.
I did not kill Rickard.
you in no way contributed to his downfall.
That was Palim.
I like how there's hardly any Catholics left in the world.
Yeah, I know, it's actually going to be pretty hard for Christianity to make a comeback here.
It's like the Chi has taken over most
like,
of Europe.
This is Norse. This is going to be Norse.
Africa's
this
Norse.
This is a write-off.
There's going to be two of us
make
left
a horse.
Three of us.
Vandalia. Yeah.
Okay, Lomandra actually lied to me because he asked for military access to get to his province.
Who's the third Catholic?
And I was like, okay, I might as well give him to be nice. And I was, I'm a generous man.
Oh.
And he goes on to kill Rickard. I'm not giving him
you have so much in common.
So what you're saying is you killed Rickard.
No, I took his military access and I was like, no, Lomandra. You're on the wrong side.
You see this massive army saying, "Oh, I just need to walk to this guy's land." You go, "Sure, why?"
No, I thought
you expanded my island first. You're the perfect white collar. I was like, "Wait, no, you want to take here?"
No one take it. No.
So here's the question: we've got two very similar flags here. The question is this part of a friendship or a rivalry? Because
yes.
It was
fantastic.
It's like we will probably eventually be enemies after he's conquered Millhaven and I conquered Padjatches.
Yes.
And we have borders in North Germany.
Yeah,
that's so he has to deal with Millhaven.
Yeah, I like to put out the Padjatches or whatever you call them. They're really, really strong.
Mm-hmm. That's the pre-combat ability from the start, and they got some pretty pretty nice land. 160 development.
Do you have any
we should actually kill them, because they're my rival.
Oh, Hessen.
Yeah, I want to kill them. Let's kill them.
I just want to humiliate
Wipe
them.
So they have Hessen, and they have
the
mercenary mate. Coincidence,
they have
I think
a
not.
Beautiful flag.
What's their morale?
No idea.
It's about half of a Prussian morale,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah, but he has lower maintenance.
Who has the highest discipline?
I don't have discipline.
When they existed, I think Rukovic had 7.5 discipline.
Yeah, he started with 7.5.
Oh, you got...
I have 10.
Oh, no, you got 5 from there, so where do you get the other...
I'm a Norse.
Oh, tier.
And they help with sailors, so I can have a decent fleet.
So you can invade Britannia, right?
No.
Okay, so you can invade Catalonia.
Yeah.
So you can invade Prussia.
So I can say... and the greatest thing of all is next week, if all works fine, blockades will be awesome.
Oh.
Oh, big plans.
Just starve people out. So, when it comes down to the fights between Catalonia and the Order of Not St. Johann, I hope the one with the better ideas wins. And that's not going to be...
Can I help? Yes, no.
Herding cats.
Yes.
Cat snip production. Oh.
Well, puns are the highest form of
humor. Well, you missed my discipline.
I like to point
this salt clean.
Yes. No, we did.
We intentionally salt. Missed it.
Yes.
I thought my ideas were bad.
And Chris, I like to point out that I think my ideas are the best written ones.
Because I wrote them.
Yeah. Some of these look awfully familiar, you know?
And a really, really great rhythm.
Corner cutting. Beautiful structures are overrated. As long as we build it quickly, aesthetics can take a back seat. Yeah, I'm curious what your build is with that, though.
Quick forts.
Gotta go fast.
Yeah. Mm. Sanic forts.
Quick, because it's gonna happen in the mid-game. Mm-hmm. Quick forts, quick manufacturers.
Uh-huh.
30% is awesome there.
Okay, well, it's been a hectic first session,
yes.
And somebody eliminated already, despite having probably the largest nation. Our laser got annihilated.
He got laser beamed.
Oh man! Uh-huh. Well, if only his allies had protected him. But
yeah, I think he's learned a lesson in who not to ally with.
Yeah, but this puts you Aquitaine in a rather juicy position, if I dare say so.
It does at the moment.
Yeah.
Come forward, Dino, since you're actually
there. There is a crazy man to my north though. He keeps causing trouble. So
yeah,
we'll have to see how that goes.
Well, you mean Germany?
Well, if you remember before how it went for Dricus. Expanded really well the first session, the second session. Oh my god, they killed Rickus!
Yeah.
Those bastards.
But then
it's
I'm
okay,
just
I'm here.
Go to South
I'm here
America
now, you're
again.
Fine.
yeah,
no check.
You sure you don't want to jump in for a session?
Oh, if anybody steps out, we'll.
All right, but hey, this dude the never lucky ideas
next
position.
Session.
Or
yeah.
Should we do them quickly now?
No, we got to save you something for next time.
So next week we'll find out what never lucky came up with.
Yeah, this is his penance for, you know, jumping on poor R Laser.
Yes.
Okay, no, that was a fantastic session. Anyone got something they want to say? You've been oddly quiet there, Groogie.
Yeah, what?
What do you got planned?
Check his nation.
You got that big smile on your face.
I'm a nice peasant republic.
You know, I've been trying to say this, like,
it's all in foreign, we'll just gobble
to you. I did give you the English translation of them.
Speak English, boy.
Don't you know where you are?
Yes. No, but my plan is to be the... For the end game, what I will be aiming for is to be the main producer of wine in the entire world.
Well, you got a bit of work to do.
Yeah. Well, Georgia is the oldest, like one of the oldest known regions for it, as we know. Something like that.
You should have the wine.
I thought the devil went down to Georgia.
Italy is a pretty large producer of wine as well. So
yeah,
there's some hostility in here.
Nice advertising.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Is that wine W-I-N-E or W-E?
Yeah.
Both. Both.
Okay. All right. Great first session. Thanks a lot for playing. Any final words before we head off to our respective watering holes?
The canopies are very
don't
tasty.
Don't nerf marches.
The hell,
salt is the
fault. I kind of missed that. I think I heard nerf marches, but
yes.
All right. Cheers, folks. We'll be seeing you next week. Cheerio for now.
Cheerio.
Salt is the fault.